Hey y'all, today I want to do a really quick video just doing some data bending of 360 video. If you've been following along, you know that last summer I did a series of databent videos with immersive audio working together with Spectral Evolver. And with the summer rolling around, we were talking about possibly doing another collaboration. So we thought, well, what's the next step? The next step is to start messing with some 360 videos. So we're just embarking on this. There's still a lot of experimentation to do, but I was just messing around this morning with Hex Fiend and I got some pretty neat results fairly easily right off the bat. And so since I've talked a little bit about Hex Fiend before, I just wanted to share that really quick. So here's the video that Will Spectral Evolver sent me. So I'm playing this back in VLC and we can see since it's a 360 video, I can drag it all around, look at things from different angles. And what's nice is we can also upload these to YouTube. And once they're up on YouTube, you can, instead of clicking around, you can move your phone or device around to look at different perspectives. If we associate this afterwards with ambisonic audio, then we can also have a 360 3D sound field as well, which is pretty neat. So just real quick, the first thing I did to try out was I duplicated my file and then I did open with Hex Fiend. So I first talked about Hex Fiend in my databending audio video, and so I'll link that here if you're interested. But essentially, Hex Fiend is a way of looking at the raw data of a file as hexadecimal numbers. So hexadecimal numbers are a great way of representing binary in a sort of shorthand. So if we're counting in hexadecimal, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 1A, 1B, etc., right? And so it's just a different way of counting, and this relates better to binary. I don't want to get too into it, but I'm sure there are lots of resources you can check out. So what I'm going to do is the same thing I did with my audio. I'm just going to do a find and replace. So first, I'm going to start by selecting all, but then I want to show you something here. First, it looks like there's a header at the very beginning here. So I'm going to hold down shift and click so that that's not selected. And then one of the things that I learned recently is a lot of these MP4 files, a lot of these video files have headers at the end too. And so we want to preserve that header. So whatever software we're opening these up with still knows how to read the file properly, especially as a 360 video. So if we look over here, these are the hexadecimal numbers. This is a ASCII representation of them. We can see that there is a bunch of information. Again, I don't know too much about these headers, but it says spherical. It's got all this information about stitching in here that I don't want to mess with. 360 videos are basically like super, super wide videos that get folded around a sphere for us to watch back and look around it. So I'm going to unselect that. Maybe I'll even go up to there. And then Command F. And I'm just going to put in a 4-digit number here. So what I'm choosing here is fairly arbitrary. The very first time I learned how to do this, it was in the Signal Culture Cookbook. There's an article, an easy 7-step protocol for data bending by Michael Betancourt, which actually has a bunch of different suggestions, but of course these depend on the codec. So, I mean, we can try this. So here we go. 7887 8778. So we're gonna find 7887 and replace it with 8778. But I strongly doubt it will have this sort of disintegration effect that he suggests here. 7887 for find, replace 8778. So what I'm doing is I'm going through the entire 600 megabytes of this file, and anytime in hexadecimal 7887 appears, I'm gonna replace it with 8778. So, replace all. Zoom. Okay. And then I'm just going to go Command S. I already duplicated this before I edit it. So I'm going to go Command S. All right. And so I might have completely broken this file because I hadn't tried those particular numbers yet. But let's see what we got. Here we are. Double click. All right. So now we have this wonderful data moshed world. Now, If we look here, this is actually the seam where it stitched the video back together. And so we're also hoping to post these initial videos, this 40-second video or something. And so if you open this up on the YouTube app on your phone, you should be able to use it to look around. And so again, it'll take the accelerometer information from your phone, and as you move that accelerometer, you can look in different directions in that 360 video. That's all I wanted to share for today. I hope it's interesting. I'll throw up a link where you can check out the 360 version of this on Spectral Evolver's channel. And if you're interested in this stuff, we're gonna keep working on it for a little while, so stay tuned.